Local history is the way that IntelliJ tracks your local, personal changes to your files. So you can open it by simply right-clicking on any file, go to local history, and say show history. This will show you the changes of your file, including commits, external changes. If I scroll down, you can see some major refactorings that happened, and other sorts of refactorings, and then just, you know, other basic changes. And then once you're on one of these changes, it shows you the diff the file. You can scroll down and revert any of the changes that you want by clicking the icons to insert the old code or remove code, or by simply reverting the entire file by right-clicking and selecting revert or create patch. Now you can also simply select a block of text and only show the changes for that selection. So you say show history for selection. Then if I scroll down here, you can see that I've made a few changes in the fields of this class. Then you can also select an entire directory or your entire project. Do show history here, and it'll show you the list of files that have changed in your local history. And then once you find the file that you want, you can double click on that and it'll bring up the diff for that file in that copy of the history. Now you can also invoke local history from the keyboard using Alt backtick. The backtick is the tilde key. And going down to local history, show history. That's just a different way to invoke it. And last but not least, you can also at any time just say local history put label, and you can just say, remember me. And then in your local history now, you'll have a custom label that shows you this file at that time that you added that label. So you can see this is just IntelliJ's way of tracking your personal changes. This isn't something that's shared across your project. It's just tracking local changes to files through external changes, commits, just regular old edits, etc. And I know that this has saved more than many developers, actually, quite a few times from, whether it's a system crash or something where your VCS just wasn't enough. Sometimes you need that extra help from your IDE of keeping your changes in its own history. So that's how you invoke it in case you need it, in case you lost some files. It may still have them in the memory. So check it out if you need it.